Welcome to my little space in YouTube. This is Mo Dine here, creator of these Pelican do-it-yourself Bluetooth boomboxes. So this is one of my latest builds. It only took a couple weekends to get this together. I'm excited because this is based off of a newer Pelican plastic hard case line. This is the Vault 100. It's designed, I think, for transporting guns and other valuables and things like that. But this Vault 100 has a little bit of a different design. It has a little bit of a more angular design. It's comparable to the Pelican 1200. Again, this is the Vault 100. So this design is actually pretty good. I have this one configured in a bi-amp configuration. So there are no passive crossover components, but I am utilizing the Dayton Audio 4-inch ND105 4 ohm drivers right here, and these are rolled off at actually using the DSP SigmaStudio. So these are, I think, crossover right around 5000 hertz, and on top are the Peerless 1-inch soft dome silk tweeters, and I got those on sale for $8 on Parts Express. Pretty much everything's coming off the Parts Express here. One other exciting thing that I'm having a lot of good luck with is the Shure Wondom 21 volt battery charging maintenance board. It works pretty well. I have it modified. They take 5 cells in series for 21 volts, but I have modified for a 2P configuration, and I've been testing it on this little Vault 100. And it seems to be very reliable, charges very well. The cool thing about the board, you can use a DC power supply anywhere from 5 to 24 volts. So, you know, as long as you have enough current, it will charge in a relatively reasonable time. And one of the boards I'm using is, let's see, it's going to be this one here. And this is the larger version. This is basically the same board that's inside, but I'm using 18650s. On the Vault 100, but this one apparently can take 26650s, or basically a larger lithium ion. But I basically have 18650s and a 3/4 inch PVC pipe just to make sure they don't fall out, but the 18650s will fit. But this board is the bigger version that's in the Vault 100, and I'll open it up and let you take a look here. One thing I like about this Vault 100 is it has push button latch system. So it takes a little push on the top to unlatch the latches, basically. So it goes something like this, there and there, just to open it up. So I'm using basically the same JAB2 and JAB3. You'll see that the JAB2 is the Shure Wondom version. It has a Bluetooth receiver in there, and this is 50 watts per channel, and those are going to the tweeters, the Peerless tweeters, and this is basically a Dayton Audio version of the Shure Wondom. It's just rebranded. It's identical. I'm pretty sure most of you guys know that. So this is 50 watts per channel. So those are going to the 4-inch drivers on the bottom, and it also has the heart of the system. I can barely see it. Let's see if I can get in there. That little square right there is the chipset for the ADAU1701. So that's the heart of the system where you can do all the programming through SigmaStudio. So the board itself, let's see if we get in here, have it kind of strapped down. It's a little bit challenging. If I wanted to This is a sure wondom board behind that red nylon strap. It's modified to accept five more lithium ion cells, 18650s. The original ones are right in here. It is kind of a weird design. I have to unbolt everything just to change out these batteries. I need to, but with these EBLs, I've had a lot of good luck. They're a great value. And so I have five more cells, three there and two there for 21 volts. And you can see they're soldered to the top of the board, modified. So far it's been working pretty well. The runtime seems to be about, gosh, at least eight to 16 hours per day, just moderate volume. There is a 6.5 inch passive radiator in the back. It's just one of the Dayton Audio newer line. It is basically a aluminum cone. And you can see the front side right here. There are no passive crossovers this time, but within SigmaStudio, I'm employing a 24 dB link width crossover DSP network. So it's all done within the programming. So you save a lot of time and energy by buying the passive crossovers and things like that. So this is a biamp setup here. So 50 watts going to the 4-inch drivers on the bottom for anything below 5,000 hertz, and everything above 5,000 hertz, another 50 watts going to the peerless tweeters right there. I've used some plexiglass just to stiffen up the front panel. It was flexing. That is one of the downsides with this box, is it seems like the construction is a little bit thinner, the plastic, than the original 1200 and that series of Pelican cases and everything. But basically I have a power switch on top, controls everything here, and this board works pretty well. So the board is on all the time, so I basically have to switch the positive side of the 24 volts and everything else is grounded. So if I turn it on here, it comes on pretty nice, no pops or clicks. Here's a battery meter here, and I also have a light for charging. Green light and red light for charging too. When the red light goes out, it means that everything's charged. Also have a Bluetooth indicator for the setup, and also a 3.5 millimeter stereo jack too, which I rarely use, but I like to have it just in case someone doesn't have Bluetooth and they want to go wired. I like this case because the handle doesn't flop around to create any kind of rattling on this Vault 100. The Vault 200, I'm going to build another one, but that, unfortunately, the handle kind of flops up and down. So I have a charging port in the back there, as usual. And then I have a 6-pin AV interface for the programming. It makes it a lot easier to just put this in there, and you don't have to have a wire sticking out for programming when you connect it to one of the ICP in-circuit programmers that Wondom makes. So this is an aluminum cone here. And I think that's about it with this build. It's a pretty simple build. It doesn't take a lot of time. I will do my usual and play half a dozen songs, tunes, and this will be just recorded with an iPhone 6 factory mic on the phone inside my garage, unfortunately. So just a small comment, doing this outside, different format in my hot garage, because my mother-in-law has been staying with us since this whole COVID mess and everything. So can't do anything on the inside of the house since she hangs out in the family room pretty much all the time. But hope you guys enjoy the video. Hit me up if you have any questions about the DSP SigmaStudio programming, and I'll do my best to answer your questions. As always, have a great day. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye. We'll be right back.
Like the dancer with bruises, who gathers the cash when the music.